Hey everyone, welcome back. We have yet another update for the Flux model. This time the model got smaller. As always, there will be links in the description below, and one of those links will bring you to this page, the Hugging Face page, and it will say Flux-FP8. This one is at floating point 8, which basically reduces the size by half. So if we go into files and versions, we'll have two models, the dev one and the Schnell one. And you can see the size is around 12 gigabyte. Now in this video, I'm going to show you how to use it. And I will also show you a comparison between the original one and this FP8 one. So once you're on this page, files and version, you can click on the download button here to download any of the model that you want to use. The Schnell version is going to be faster since it's generally trained to output an image between 1 to 4 steps. The dev version, you will usually go to 20 steps or more. Now, as for the workflow, it is exactly the same as the original one. So if you go to the top where we have the load diffusion model, as you can see at the top here in the unit name, I've selected the original one, Flux Schnell. And then I have another one that says Flux 1 Schnell FP8. You can leave the other things the same with your prop. Now for this particular test, I've gone ahead and fixed the seed to a random number. And here's the result. So this is from the original model, the 23 point something gigabyte model. And my prop here says basically a woman holding a sign saying Flux is awesome. And then we have an exclamation mark, and it was able to output it. Even though like the aspect ratio was not ideal, the awesome part got cut off, but it was able to do it. Now I have another version that I've done here. So number one under my history, and it appears that nothing changed. But if we go into the load diffusion model, here you can see that I am using the FP8. Everything is the same, same seed. And I would say it's the exact same image. If I switch between number 0 and 1 here, so this is 0, the original one. This is number 1. I don't really see much of a difference, to be honest. So from this test, I'm going to say that you would not be losing a lot in terms of quality, but it's half the size. It may take less time, and obviously it's going to take less resources. So that was a quick update concerning the Flux model. Now I got a comment in my last video saying that Flux cannot do realistic image. And that is true considering that it is open source, it is free, and it's also for commercial purposes. Obviously, there are some restrictions when you're making something free and available for commercial purposes. You cannot really train it on people's face, for example. But there's a way around it. So once you have your image here, you can take the latent output here. Let me drag it down, reroute, and bring it down. And then you can pass this to an SDXL or SD1.5 model. So as an example, it's going to look something like this. All right. So this is just a simple text to image workflow. Basically the default one that you get, load checkpoint, clip, ksampler, VA decode, and then save image. And for the latent image, you can take the one that's coming from the sampler custom advance. I've just put a reroute node here, so I can take it from here, drag it inside the latent image, and then change the knee noise to something. You can try 0.5, 0.4, depending on how strong your base model is. In this particular case, it's, I believe this one is SD1.5, and then I have SDXL here. These two are going to be SDXL version. But I don't prefer to use it inside of ComfyUI like this, because if I want to change just one aspect of it, right now, the way that it is, it's going to modify the entire image. So if I leave everything as is, click on the Q prompt, it's going to change everything, including the text. So if you have text in your generated output from Flux, then this method is not really good. If there were no text in there, you can give it a try. Instead, I prefer to do inpainting, because then I can mask out where I want this checkpoint, whichever checkpoint that you've selected, to modify or change the image. Now you can do inpainting inside of ComfyUI, and just as an example, to do it, you will add a VA encode for inpainting, and then just make sure you're connecting everything. So pixel is going to be the image, this image. So you will need to take the image from VA decode here. If you have a dedicated VA, you can use the load VA. And then there's the mask. So you will need to add the mask separately. Now you can use a load image and draw the mask from there. So take the mask here. You can also get this image, drag it inside here, and then draw your mask like that. You can use any of the automated way of generating mask. In ComfyUI, there are multiple ways of doing so. However, I found this particular workflow a little bit too messy. Instead, what I prefer to do is generate the image inside of ComfyUI using Flux, and then I just transfer it inside of Fooocus. And this is Fooocus, and the idea here is that it's a simpler interface for a stable diffusion. So all I need to do is to go into this input image down. It will open some tabs, and we can do various things in here. We can do some variation. What I'm interested in doing is inpaint or outpaint. So I'm going to click there. Then take the image, drag it over to the inpaint area here. We simply need to paint the area that you want to change. So let's say, for example, we want to change just the face. So you can paint here. And then at the bottom here, it gives you a different method. In this particular case, I want to say improve detail, face, hand, eyes, and then describe it. So we can say highly detailed face. Let me just say woman face, and then beautiful eyes. Now for the prompt at the top, I'm going to type in the same thing from ComfyUI, with the exception of the text part. Now I also like to go into the advanced option here, and then for me, it's already selected as extreme speed. It's basically like an LCM workflow. I'm going to change my aspect ratio to 1280 by 720. Some of you may not have this aspect ratio. You can check some of the other one. Now, what's really good about Fooocus is that we can go into models. In the model section, we have a base model, which is SDXL only. In this particular case, I'm going to go with realistic stock photo. And then I'm also able to select a style. So I'm going to go with, let's just go with SDXL film photography. Now we can also add a refiner, which can be SDXL or SD 1.5. So once you're done, you can click on the generate button here. All right, so it's completed and we can see the result at the top. So as you can see, we now have a different face. Now, I would say that the skin tone doesn't exactly match, so we'll need to play with the settings under the advanced section here. There's a developer debug mode, and there are so many settings that you can play with. But that's basically how I would say that you can try to get some styles from SD 1.5. as well as SDXL to your Flux images. Now, we can do this exact same thing inside of ComfyUI, like I said. You just need to look into your workflow and see what exactly you want to do. If you want to change everything, simply pass the final image as the latent image, change the denoise steps. If you want to do inpainting, then you will have to go with some kind of inpaint option. This is the most basic in paint that you can do inside of ComfyUI. You can also use the set latent noise mask to do in painting. Now, if you want to, you can also send this to a face detailer workflow, to an upscaler workflow, and basically you don't have to restrict yourself do just these nodes. Yes, these are the basic node that is required in order to do generation using Flux, but you can also take the output and pass it to a different workflow. So I hope this video gave you some insight on the FP8. So if any of you were not able to run the full model, maybe now you can give this one a try and see if you're able to generate images. All right, thank you for watching. I hope you have a great day ahead, and I will see you in the next one.